Welcome. You are about to enter a place you've never been before. A place where dreams are made reality. And now.
Welcome to the one and the only DITC Social with your host, Andre Pru-M.
Powered by Gatineau.tv, Angelic Empowerment International Network, and BlasterRadio.com. Hello, bonjour, and welcome to DITC Social, live on Facebook, Twitch, YouTube, and BlasterRadio.com. I am so glad to have you joining me this evening. Thank you. Thank you to the 1,022 page likes and the 1,411 followers. Diverse Indie Capital was born in 2019, and now is expanding and including the amazing BlasterRadio.com. We love you, Milky. Thank you so much for having us. Tonight, we'll be discussing some hot topics, but keeping them light and fluffy and taking some of your questions. So feel free to comment on whatever platform that you are on and we'll bring you into the conversation. Ce soir, nous discutons de certains sujets, mais en les gardant légers et amusants et en répondant à certaines de vos questions. Alors, n'hésitez pas de faire part d'avec vos commentaires, que ce soit sur la plateforme sur laquelle que vous vous trouvez. Et nous ferons participer à la conversation. We pay respect to all Indigenous peoples in this region from all nations across Canada who call Ottawa home. We acknowledge the traditional knowledge keepers, both young and old, and we honor their courageous leaders past, present, and future. Nous rendons également hommage à tous les peuples autochtones qui habitent Ottawa, que ce soit de la région ou d'ailleurs au Canada. Nous reconnaissons les gardiens des savoirs traditionnels, jeunes et âgés. Et nous honorons aussi la courageuse dirigeante d'hier, d'aujourd'hui et de demain. I want to preface this conversation by stating that this is a safe space and that our conversation today is based on mutual respect, openness, and understanding. Je tiens à préciser que nous sommes dans un contexte sécuritaire et que la conversation d'aujourd'hui doit être imprégnée de respect mutuel, d'ouverture et de compréhension. Tonight on DITC Social, we speak to Tina Walter, who is a diversity, equity, and inclusion professional and has been contracted by the National Arts Center to explore ways that that organization can become more inclusive organization. We got our weekly tarot card reading from Lillian Carrière, and my song producer extraordinaire, Russian Noise, is here to give us a sneak peek of my song that we're going to be releasing on Sunday afternoon. Ce soir sur DIT Social, nous jaserons avec Tina Walker, qui est une professionnelle de la diversité, de l'équité et de l'inclusion. Elle a été engagée par le Centre national des arts pour explorer les moyens de rendre l'organisation plus inclusive. Nous recevons notre carte de tarot hebdomadaire en direct de Lillian et mon producteur de chansons extraordinaire, Russian Noise, est là pour nous donner un aperçu de ma chanson et comment est-ce qu'on l'a réalisé en même temps. DITC Social is an LGBTQ2+ news and entertainment style show, and if you want to come on DITC Social to promote your business or your event, send me an email at andre@diverseintocapital.tv. DIT Social est une émission d'information et de divertissement sur le thème des LGBTQ2+, et si vous voulez venir sur DIT Social pour promouvoir votre entreprise ou votre événement, envoyez-moi un courriel à andre@commercial.diversityinthecapital.tv. Now, let's get into some of the hellos. Oh, we got Chrissy watching. Hello, Miss Chrissy. Welcome. Miss Allison Wadden, welcome. Thank you so much. And my beautiful Julie's here too. Thank you so much all for being here. Just a reminder that when Lillian's on a little later and she pulls her tarot card, you're going to be able to ask questions. So if the card relates to you in any way, you're going to be able to get a little more answers on what it means for you. All right. Without further ado, my first guest is on her way. And here comes Tina Walter on DITC Social.
Hey, everybody. What's going on? I'm Theo Tams, and you are watching DiversityInTheCapital.tv.
Greetings, Ottawa, Canada. This is Chad Michaels from RuPaul's Drag Race.
Hi, Ottawa and Gatineau. I'm Carol Pope, and you're watching Diversity in the Capital.
Hello, Ottawa. It's your girl, Sylvanda.
Hey, it's Eva Avila.
Hi, I'm Rhea May, and you're watching Diversity in the Capital.tv.
Diversity in the Capital.tv.
Bonjour DTC Social, ici Alex de Jeunesse STEM. Malheureusement, la pandémie de la COVID-19 a forcé beaucoup de jeunes LGBTQIA de plus à s'isoler, que ça soit mentalement, socialement ou d'une autre façon. Jeunesse STEM est là pour vous. Nous sommes la ressource pour les jeunes allosexuels de la région de l'Outaouais. On t'encourage à participer à nos groupes de soutien pour nos jeunes de 14 à 25 ans, de prendre rencontre avec moi de façon individuelle ou de recommander l'organisme à quelqu'un qui pourrait en avoir de besoin. Pour plus d'informations, tape Jeunesse STEM sur Facebook ou Instagram.
My first guest is Tina Walter. Tina Walter is a recently retired executive public servant, and she has always been passionate about diversity, equality, and inclusion. Influenced early in her life when she was an international athlete and growing up in Jamaica. This passion has been reflected in her subject matter master's thesis at Western University and her continuing education at Cornell University. With her work in the city of Ottawa to increase representation of visible minorities in the police force, among firefighters, as well as her work on diversity and inclusion in various federal government departments. More recently, Tina has been engaged by the National Arts Center to help them open their doors virtually, physically, and culturally, so that two LGBTQ2+ communities, individuals, and organizations are included. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Tina. Welcome, Tina. How are you, my dear?
Oh, thank you so much. Fortunately, I'm well. I'm double vaxxed. My wife is double vaxxed. My mom is double vaxxed. My sister is double vaxxed. So, you know, and everybody is doing well. And I have to say, Andre, I am so grateful that I discovered you, or maybe you discovered me, but I think I discovered you first.
I think you did. And I'm so glad that you reached out, because I mean, I've been begging the community to come on in here. And when you said you wanted to come in, so you don't necessarily work for the NAC, you've been contracted out for them, right? So you're not a spokesperson for the National Arts Center.
No, I'm not.
All right. So do you want to tell me about your initiative and what it's all about?
Sure. I'll try to summarize a bit. So I'll give a bit of the context, right? Because we know that recent events, what I call tip of the iceberg in the United States and in Canada, in terms of exclusionary practices, tip of iceberg with respect to hate crimes, with respect to exclusionary practices that are very obvious, with respect to marginalized Canadians, we know that that has been going on, mm-hmm. unfortunately. And that is a driver, actually, in our country, I think, that has, for example, influenced movements such as Black Lives Matter, movements such as We Too, and also movements with respect to, and historically, with respect to pride. So the context, I think, is that many institutions in Canada, including the National Arts Center, have begun to recognize that it is very important to pay full attention to exclusionary practices in very important organizations and institutions.
Okay.
So that's a bit of the context. So the National Arts Center, in its wisdom, developed a 3-year strategic plan, which heavily focuses on trying to find out more barriers to exclusionary practices of, let's call it, marginalized groups. So they started an initiative to focus on wanting to hear the voices of marginalized communities and individuals and those folks involved in the arts in order to improve their inclusive programming, their even internally within their organization in terms of the diversity of their employees. So all this to say is that I think it's really great. It is timely. The National Arts Center has already started to become a more inclusive organization. For example, they have the French Theater, They have also now the Indigenous Theater, which allows voices to be heard of, let's say, what NAC still is struggling with, and that is a reputation and an image that potentially gives the impression that it is white, heterosexual, abled.
Okay.
So my focus specifically is on responding to this question. How can the National Arts Center improve its inclusionary practices within the context of engaging the two-spirited LGBTQ community, not the, but two-spirited LGBTQ plus communities, particularly within the National Capital Region. So what I've been doing is reaching out to these communities and individuals, and those individuals who are either allies or members of these communities. And I'm a member of the community as well. I'm married to a woman.
And how long?
Don't tell her, because sometimes I forget. I'm really sorry.
Okay. It's been many years, right? It's like
10 years last year.
Okay, I'll promise not to tell her. Just don't let her watch this after it's over. Well, that's a long time. That's good. Congratulations.
Yes. So my objective is to, as best as possible, engage communities within, particularly within the National Capital Region, for now.
Okay.
And there are various reasons why that's the case with respect to the National Arts Center. But my task at hand is to hear in an authentic way from the two-spirited LGBTQ plus communities within the National Capital Region, to hear their voices, to identify potential barriers that exist.
Okay.
Why is National Arts Center not attractive to me? As a performer, as a potential audience, as a potential arts organization that, could need support for funding and so forth.
So does it have a bad reputation within, I'm a community member too. I've been in the gay community for 25 years and I've seen many, I wouldn't necessarily say gay events, but like I saw Theo Tams there one night and he's a well-known LGBTQ2+ Canadian idol. And it was the best concert. Like I cried from the moment I sat down to the moment I left. And then I kept crying when I partied with him at the local, not too far from there. So it is showing representation. I think they had the Aboriginal Awards there as well, or the Indigenous Awards back in the days. So why? See, I'm also a federal employee, so I'm trying not to wear two hats right now, because I just did a panel discussion last week on the art of drag, because, a few things hit the media that they weren't impressed with, the government spending money on drag queens. And it wasn't any money being spent. It was government employees teaching other government employees to be their true self and have fun and be creative and show your true natural self. But
Well, the word that you said, that word authenticity is very, very, very important. And I think the National Arts Center is looking for more authenticity within its organizational culture and with respect to, with respect to engaging whole communities.
Okay.
Much more within its space.
Okay. So you've reached out to some of the 2S LGBTQ2+ communities. What have you heard so far?
So far, it's interesting. So I'm using two approaches. One was a survey that went out. And, very interesting. I shouldn't reveal the results before I go back to National Arts Center.
Is the survey still active? Like, can other people join and fill this survey out?
Yes, even though I have a deadline with respect to, because, you know, we have to follow some timelines in terms of taking action.
Yeah.
Because we want to make sure that even though this is a, let's say this is a first phase, because I assume that the National Arts Center wants to develop a relationship with the Two-Spirit
communities.
Yes. And to continue that relationship over time, because, mm-hmm. you know, solutions are not only a one-time thing.
Yeah.
If you don't know your audience, if you don't know the barriers that they're facing, whether you're a performer or a part of an audience, if there are issues, for example, here's one issue that I think has come to the fore, affordability.
Mm-hmm. Well, mm-hmm. yeah, that's across the country.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Affordability, and also, even though we're in a COVID situation, slowly maybe getting out of that situation, you know, the National Arts Center has attempted in many ways to offer programming in a virtual way.
Yeah.
So one issue that maybe to address what I'm hearing is, for example, if I'm a clearly identified gay person walking physically into NAC, the one Elgin Street where it physically is located,
yes.
do I feel safe?
Oh, I've had this conversation actually with John Milkman from the radio station. Like, do you feel safe walking down on Bank Street in the village, holding hands with your partner?
Well, you know, I tell you, I'm small but fierce, apparently.
But I'm a drag queen, and I am afraid to walk hand in hand with a significant other in this city. In Toronto, no problem. I will walk down, or in Montreal, I would walk down Saint-Catherine, no problem holding hands with somebody. But in this city where I actually live, even though we have the four blocks for the village, yeah. I still wouldn't hold hands with somebody.
Yeah, and even though we have Bank Street, that is pretty famous in Ottawa for having LGBTQ two-spirited
colors. Flags there, but it still doesn't make it safe.
Exactly. So these are the kinds of issues that may be still persisting that pose barriers to the National Arts Center and other sectors of the organization being more inclusive and more aware of what are the very important lived experiences of marginalized people. In my case, what are the important lived experiences that folks in the National Capital Region who are either members or allies of two-spirited LGBTQ plus individuals and communities and organizations, what are their lived experiences, both with respect to being an audience, potential audience, participating in enjoying performances.
Anybody could rent any of those spaces themselves to do an event as well, right? So you want to be able to feel safe and secure of renting the space for your event of choice.
And so, also the appreciation of the history and putting the history and wonderful accomplishments, regardless of barriers, of what I'm focused on, not only marginalized group, but also of two-spirited LGBTQ plus. Can you imagine exposing everyone more to the value added of marginalized communities?
Oh, well, there's certainly. So this isn't one of the questions, but I want to ask you, in the intro, you talked about having to desensitize the police department and the fire department. Mm-hmm. How was that working with considering everything happening where the community didn't want the police involved anymore? And I wasn't one of them, because they kept us safe during our prides. And the gay prides turned into celebrations, but they were always about marches and always about needing to move forward, and we still got lots of work to do. So how was it working with them, and what did you accomplish? Anything good by doing that, or
actually,
how did you feel?
It's a good question, but what that was history, because I was part of the Visible Minority Committee for three years with the City of Ottawa, focused on police and firefighters. But that was in the 90s. Can you imagine?
You were what?
In the 90s.
Oh, okay. Oh, that was long ago. That was before any of this happened.
So I'm actually, it's a good question, Andre, because I do wonder, wow. So, okay, so we got them, the City of Ottawa, the police and firefighters, to set targets.
Yeah.
I remember actually being a part of the Visible Minority Committee way back when, and there was a debate in the committee about including two-spirited, we didn't call our community two-spirited LGBTQ2+, the LGBTQ+ at the time.
Yeah.
Well, why don't we consider gay people in all of what we're doing? Well, you know, back then, but fortunately, I'm hoping, this word intersectionality comes into play. So I don't know what's happening yet these days with respect to the police and how they respond to community issues, protect communities that could be at risk and so forth. I'm not sure anymore. However, one of the things that I know that the police had started to do when I was dealing with them back then was the concept of community policing. That means then that you get to know police officers, they are in your community, they are not supposed to be feared, but to be help protect us from harm.
Yeah.
But I'm not anymore aware of what's happening these days.
All right. Well, we'll have to check in with that. We got a Glenn is saying that this is great to have this outreach from the National Arts Center. So several community members are applauding you. So you mentioned that you have a couple of focus groups and sessions coming up in providing ideas. If anybody's interested in providing ideas, is there a contact that you could provide for those listening or watching that
yes.
might be interested?
Absolutely. And thank you for those. Thanks so much for those who are interested. So there are two sessions that will be held, one French, one English. Parce que j'adore la langue française. En fait, je pense que la langue française est la plus belle langue au monde.
C'est la langue de l'amour.
Oui, absolument, sans question. So, one September 7th, because I think it's a long holiday happening over the weekend.
This weekend, yes.
And of course, we want to accommodate as much as possible people because we know they're working and everybody's busy. Eh?
Yeah.
So, appreciate the volunteer efforts on the part of those who are interested. So September 7th will be the English session from 5 to 7:30, 5:30 to 7. And then the French session is September 8th at the same time. But if people want to, which I would welcome, want to register, I'll give you my email address.
Okay.
So all lowercase.
Hold on. Here, let me put it in the comments and then everybody will get it at the same time. So go ahead.
Merci beaucoup.
Go ahead with it.
Say Tina Walter.
Yeah.
At rogers.com.
So Tina Walter, all one word, at rogers.com.
Yeah.
There we go. So it's been sent to all three platforms. Everybody's got it. Please, if you are in the nation's capital or anywhere within the country and you want to help see diversity, because what they do at the National Arts Center could be reflected across the country as well, right? To a lot of different venues that are just starting to reopen. I know Broadway's only opening up in this month, I think, September or October. So make sure you go out, support the arts, because like we were talking earlier, food and arts and the community all go together because, well, generally they're all made up of the community as well, right?
Yes. Absolutely, Andre.
Well, thank you so much, Tina, for being here. I appreciate it. You're welcome to stay and keep watching until the end of the show, but you are welcome to log off and keep watching on whatever social platform. Thank you. And I look forward to seeing what you've got going on coming up soon.
Yes. And oh, by the way, Andre, you are invited to one of the sessions.
I think I just may. I will probably register for the one on September 7th just to see what it's all about, because you got to put your money where your mouth is, right?
Absolutely. No question.
Well, I'll see you on September 7th, girl. I'll register after the show.
Okay. Excellent.
Lillian Carrière is up next with her tarot card reading, and you're going to be able to ask questions coming up on DITC Social on Blast the Radio.
Gatineau.tv est partout en Outaouais, autant au niveau de la culture, de l'événementiel, mais aussi au niveau de vos entreprises. Si vous avez un projet spécial que vous aimeriez promouvoir, un événement que vous avez créé, eh bien, n'hésitez pas à parler avec un de nos représentants à Gatineau.tv. Vous pouvez nous écrire à via notre adresse info@gatineau.tv. Vous aussi, prenez avantage de Gatineau.tv.
Gatineau.tv.
Incredible sounds.
Oh my Levi's. I got the fuse if you got the light. I got the all if y'all got the night. All night.
Shoes and grab a beverage. VTR's Capital Queer Tea Dance with DJ D-Wall-Wee.
Ah, yes. Well, I screwed up and that commercial was supposed to be in between the next two, but whatever, we'll adjust. This is live television. Welcome to DITC Social. Who am I today? Oh, yes, Andre. There is so much going on. My new single is coming out later on this week, so we're going to be talking about that a little bit later on. But first, we need to get this week's tarot card reading, and Lillian Carrière is here live and here with me now, where did I put your intro? Like, really? Oh, there it is. Here comes Lillian.
Welcome to From Where I Sit, featuring Lillian Carrière. An enlightening and insightful journey to awaken insight into conscious living, personal growth, spirituality, love, and relationships, and other related topics. We hope you will be inspired and blessed by this journey. Grab a chair, sit with us.
Hi, Lillian.
Hi, everyone. I'm so excited to be back. Yay. Woohoo.
I know. I feel like I'm so out of whack. It's like, you know, when you're like, they say you never forget how to ride a bicycle. You actually do forget how to do your own live show every once in a while, too, if you don't do it for 2 months. And I just realized today I could put videos in order, and I put them all in order, and I'm still not following it. So I've got some learning to do. But so what do you got for us this week?
Well, let's find out.
All right, I'm going to make myself smaller and put you bigger, and let's you go at it, girl.
So hi, everyone. My name is Lillian Carrière, and I'm an angelic intuitive and medium, and welcome to From Where I Sit. And this week, we are going to pull up some guardian angel tarot cards and find out what the soup du jour or the focus is for this week. So I'm going to ask your guides, my guides, and universe divine for the best possible soup du jour.
I Is there someone at your door, Lillian?
It's an alarm, actually, to remind us something. All right. All right, everybody, look at that. Pop. I love it when they pop like this. And what an unexpected surprise when they do come up. So I have the Eight of Abundance here with me today. And it reads, this is a time of learning and honoring your skills. You may feel inspired to go back to school, take seminars on topics that fascinate you, or educate yourself on the healing arts. This is a good time to change your jobs or make a career move for yourselves. The key to your success this week is in all your details. Monitor your projects very carefully. Love this sweet little card. You can see the two children here. See if I can bring it up. That you can see the two children here on a chalkboard trying to figure out the answer to this mathematical problem. So some wonderful times of change and putting things in perspective and moving forward. If you're thinking of changing a career, go for it, everyone. If you're thinking of learning some new skill or taking up a new hobby or a different type of social activity, this is the time to do it. This is the time for success. That's what I got.
So if anybody's watching and you have any other questions that circle around what that is, I mean, that was great because we just had a whole talk about diversity and inclusion, and there's a lot of learning and teaching, and we all still have lots. Like, just because Pride season is over, it doesn't mean that it stops there. We still got to keep fighting for each other. And that was one of the things that I was talking about in the seminar that I did last week. It's just, even though I don't necessarily belong to Black Lives Matter, it doesn't mean I can't be an ally for them. And just because they might not be gay, it doesn't mean that they can't be an ally for us, right? So we need to lift each other up and empower each other. And we are stronger with more voices than one, right? So
we need to rise above the ego.
Yes.
Rise above the ego and get the hell out of the age of Pisces. We enter
My mother and my sister are Pisces, so I know exactly what you're talking about.
We enter into the age of Aquarius around Christmas time. And for the first time, Saturn and the planet came close for the first time in 6 million years.
Wow.
We are now in the age of Aquarius. I think people really need to wake up. Wake up and smell the coffee and go beyond the ego. You know, we look in the mirror every day and we don't think we're good enough because we compare ourselves to what other people see as a, quote, label of what we should look like or what we should be doing in our lives. We should be doing this and that. So yeah,
we need to stop labeling each other and ourselves as well, right? Like my neighbors.
Our spirits having a human experience. And if we kept it to the fact that we are spiritual beings enjoying this human experience, the good, the bad, because we live in a polarized world.
Yeah.
We have negative and positive, and they go together.
Well, that's the thing, is that like my neighbor's daughter decided that she told her parents she was pansexual 1 week. And then like a couple of weeks later, she came. She's like, so I think I'm bisexual. And my neighbor was like, what the hell do I do? And I didn't really know what to say, but I ended up getting a second new progressive flag. And I've learned that the new progressive flag has the chevron to show that progress still needs to be made. And that's why it's pointing towards the rest of the rainbow, right? Because they've added all the extra colors to include a lot more. Not that nobody shouldn't feel included into the LGBTQ2+ community, because the alphabet already is so long that if
we
you
don't
feel, that feel included, like I just don't understand it anymore. But that being said, I gave her the flag and I said, I'm giving you this flag. And I'm going to ask you one favor. And I said, I want you to stop labeling yourself and stop rushing to label yourself. Because
Amen.
I labeled myself 25 years ago as gay. And now I associate myself as being queer.
Well, you know, I was just reflecting on what you said and went back to Tina, the way she was speaking earlier.
Yeah.
To have that inclusiveness, that freedom, like in the 1990s, wow, I remember the 1980s and having eggs thrown at me and these Bible thumpers coming down the parades with us.
Yeah.
We started off, I think, with maybe 30 people. The Leathers walked with us, I know. And today, it's so much more common. And I think the more we make it common to be who we are, whether that's straight or whatever the case is, that's
whatever
what we're doing on this earth. In the meantime, our spirits are learning, growing, and experiencing things. And that goes with us on to the divine, that beautiful energy that keeps this world circulating. It's pretty deep, I know.
No, that's good. And Julie is chiming in saying we shouldn't need to advocate for equality and just treat everyone with respect in who they are. And it is true. Like they always said when you were younger, treat those the way you want to be treated. And it still is to this day. If you want to be treated like an SOB, then act like one. Because I'll totally treat you like one, right? A couple of years ago, I used to differ on that one. What?
I beg to differ in what you just said. I'm not the vindictive type. I will let their energy stay with them and, you know, just keep on rolling. Why bother spending my time in that energy when I could be somewhere else embracing the future?
And I'm getting to be like that. I used to be where I wouldn't get mad. I get even. Like, you ain't going to see.
Oh, you got to let that shield go, honey.
And if I'm mad at you and I'm smiling at you, that's because I've thought of doing something or I've already done it. But now I'm at the point where I'm totally, it's like water off a duck's back. Like, if you're going to be angry and be all you're in your own little situation, I ain't got no time for that. I'm not going to sit there and dwell on certain things that it doesn't matter.
You'll make yourself sick.
Exactly.
Physically, mentally, and emotionally, you won't even want to get your butt out of bed if you dwell on it. If you let the ego take over.
Exactly.
Again, the polarized thing, the Jiminy Cricket, where you have the angel with the halo on one side, and then the little devil with. Red devil with the red horns.
Yeah, it's called being a Gemini, honey. I just look in the mirror and I have that whole conversation by myself every day.
Social butterflies are my Geminis.
Yes.
You've been getting around yourself lately there. You're doing a lot of live on locations.
We are, yes. And the station's going to be doing a lot more different things coming up too. So yeah, we're creating a fad. And we're going to have you at some of these as well, that you're going to be coming to do some live readings with some folks, all right?
I certainly hope so. I'm starting to wonder if I'm the black sheep of this family.
No. The first three that I did was a test, and the venues were too small for that. But maybe we can have you down this Sunday, because I'm going to be there from 2 p.m. to 7, and maybe we can find a little table for you and we can see if you can do a couple of readings for some folks and bring out some good juju for the new CD, the new single that's coming out. So
I'd love to do that. And if they wanted to leave a donation, we could send that to Brew's house.
There we go. So, okay, well, let's work out a nice little table for you on Sunday and we'll give a little extra from the cycle and everything that we did. How about that?
Oh, yeah, we'll go out. I'm excited. Thank you.
Oh, yes. Does anybody have any questions while Lillian is here? We still got a little bit of time if anybody wants to ask anything.
I kind of see in Twitch, do you see anything, Lillian, from Superfan Kiss Chrissy?
Superfan Chrissy.
Can I answer her question?
Sure, if you want to, yeah.
Do I see anything for you?
I gave you 15 minutes, like, girl. Do whatever you want with it.
I see from your energy right away. If you could put that back up, Andre, so I could see your photo. I really tune in that way. I can see from the energy just from this photo. I know it's an older photo, but I feel like you're a little bit in a rut right now, and I want to put that quite politely. I'm concerned a little bit for your health and your ability to breathe. I don't know if it's dusty where you are, or maybe you need to do some dusting, but please look into that. Or maybe it's an allergy of some sort that's going on. I feel like your face turns pinkish and stuff like that when the allergy is showing up, or you're very, you have that very sensitive skin. So look into taking care and nurturing your skin and drink more water. I have the Eight of Thought here for you. Super friend Chrissy. I'm sorry if I'm not saying
super fan Chrissy.
Thank you. Okay, so I have the Eight of Thought here, and it reads, you may feel as though you're restricted by the circumstances you find yourself in, but that's just an illusion. Make a promise to yourself to refuse to be stuck in a situation that's making you unhappy at this point. Don't wait for someone to come to rescue you. Rescue and free yourself. I love this. It's talking about the only thing that's stopping you and preventing you from moving forward is yourself. And I think that's where I felt the energy, where you're kind of like dragging yourself, where you're having difficulty. You know, you need your ass kicked out of bed to get things done. You've got this overwhelming feeling going on. I don't know if you suffer a depression or not, but honey, it's up to you. It's up to you.
So I know Chrissy, and she worked very, very hard the last several months with all the vaccinations.
She's exhausted.
Yeah. And it takes a toll on you, right? We got another question from Julie. See anything on my daughter's health issues?
Your daughter is going to be just fine. I feel like what she has right now, Julie, is kind of off and on. So it could be like an illness that flares up for a while where it affects her, and then she's good for a few months or a few weeks, sometimes a few years, and the flare will come back. I feel like this will be a continuous thing and need to be monitored, you know, by seeing a doctor yearly. Nothing, I don't feel like it's anything completely that's going to, you know, she's not going to die if that's what you're concerned about. She's going to be going up and down like that. But Julie, you already know this. You're a mother. You know that one minute you're worrying about this part of their health, and the next minute, bam, something else happens that you're worried about with that particular child. We never stop worrying as parents.
Take the training wheels off, Julie. It's time.
We never stop being parents. We never. You know, my daughter is in her 40s. And she's still my baby girl.
Yeah.
And if it's not one thing, it's going to be another. Not to say that you don't need a tarot read for that, but honey, I feel like what she has is just up and down. It's a matter of a good diet and keeping things monitored.
Well, so hopefully these BTR folks will come out on Sunday for the Capital Quarantine Dance. And Yvonne is saying hello. Hello, Miss Yvonne.
Hi, Yvonne. Thanks for coming, joining here. It's so... yeah, I didn't even need a card for that one. Hopefully that helps. And if you want to have a more in-depth reading, contact me on my, you know, at link. You are in at Linktree, or you'll see me
on the Facebook page. Well, so Lillian might be there on Sunday. We're going to get you a table on Sunday. So if you do want to come down for a live reading, it'll be all out in the open outdoors. So COVID friendly, and the entire event is going to be outside. So
absolutely, and all, if there's any donations, it's gonna go all to Bruce House. I just
we'll
want to
talk about that, but yeah, we can that'll be great. If you want to do some donations to Bruce House, that would be very much appreciated. Thank you so much for being here. I cannot wait to see what next week has in store for us. So remind us again about the first card. What was it again?
It is the Eight of Abundance.
The Eight of Abundance. All right. So if you want to see the card, you can
get the career, making those plans. 2 + 2 = 4. Let's go for it this week.
And it's the Diana Carroll cards or Diana
Guardian Angel.
Oh, the Guardian Angel ones. Okay. Because you use so many. I try to remember which ones it is.
I have over 200 decks going on. I just love artwork.
Bring the heart ones. I like those. We have to.
All right, I'll bring them next week.
Those are
for Sunday. Absolutely, they're being charged right now with a crystal.
Okay, good. Well, thank you, Lillian, and I can't wait to see what you've got going on next week. Stick around if you want to hear a sneak peek of my song coming up.
Yes, I will.
Thank you, darling. See you soon. All right. So, without further ado, je m'appelle André, and now I'm going to accueillir my amazing recording artist, producer. I screwed up all the commercials things, so there's no commercials in between. That's just the way it is. Rush and Noise, we're going to tell the story of how this song came to be, and you're going to hear a little snippet of it. I've been begging him for, I would probably say, 2 years to record a song. And I wanted to record a song with another fellow LGBTQ2+ artist friend of mine, but he's been very busy. So I managed to get one, and hopefully the other one will follow. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the extraordinary DJ producer, Russian Noise. Good afternoon or evening, monsieur.
The other producer?
The other producer? No, the other person. I mean, sorry, the other person. I'm talking about Drake. Jesus Christ. I've been wanting to sing with Drake for I don't know how many years. And I figured if I get my hands on your cojones, then the other one will follow and they'll want to do something too. So how's it going, Daddy?
It's done. The song is done.
The song is done. Well, it took a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. I do have to say we both put a lot of work into that, and more so you for editing it all together and putting it all together. So what were your highlights?
It was a rough ride. I mean, when we decided to make this single, you know, Trudeau hadn't made these plans happen.
Bad decisions.
Yeah. And when that happened, my job went into overdrive, and it got incredibly insane. And I ended up having so much work coming from all sides, and it just got really, really difficult to try to concentrate on one thing at a time when you got all this pressure coming from behind you,
Just to explain to the folks at home is that so Eric in Montreal does a lot of stuff for the media. So a lot of events, media boxes, he does, takes care of a lot of events. So anytime something huge in the media happens, he gets very busy. And you were in Ottawa here, and we were recording, I think, that weekend when that whole media thing blew up. I was in Montreal. We recorded in Montreal that week.
Yeah, we started in Montreal. It didn't pan out that well because we were just overbared with
writer's block.
I was. And
the cheap beer at the Black Eagle. Like, seriously, let's be honest.
And the great food. What was that restaurant?
Oh my God. I don't remember. I was so drunk. I don't remember. I remember I ate something. I don't remember what it was.
It was so much fun. We went shopping as well.
We went shopping. We got to see a little bit of the city. Like, that's what I was telling Tina earlier. Like, St. Catherine is so bustling. Like, every single patio was packed with people just sitting there. And the fact, like, and then I recorded that drag queen on the street on that Sunday, and everybody thought it was me.
Yeah, Tracy.
Mainly because she was performing a friggin' Celine Dion song, and they're like, oh, you looked really good. I've never seen you look like that. I'm like, good, because that wasn't me. That was the queen from Montreal.
That's Tracy, like, Trash, my nose, yeah.
Tracy Trash. Well, Horizon is pretty much trash too, but so we could be sisters. I don't know. Like, my sister from another sister. I don't know.
We got it done. I mean, it's a week late. We wanted to get it done by Pride. And
we did.
First off, the recordings went bad, and then we had to re-record again.
Re-record. So this beautiful microphone is beautiful. And I was like, oh my God, I got the best microphone. We're going to record with this. This is good for talk shows, not good for a sound studio. Even though not I had my own little dome around it. Yeah. So we had to do it all again.
Guard in the front.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
The thing is, some microphones are made for radio and television and internet work. And then you got a mic
thing for faces. Some faces are made for radio and television and internet.
That's why we have makeup. So
yeah.
we got microphones like these, which is what we used afterwards. And with the big foamy.
With the big, yes, my cat loves to find those. I have to hide them because they find them in my studio and then they disappear with them.
They just disappear. Yeah. So, like I said, we ended up with some delays and having so much work to be for me, not being able to catch up. It was pretty difficult. And as you said, I work in the media. Basically, my whole entire title is I am a technician, engineer, operator, and designer in sound, lighting, visual effects, and pyrotechnics.
My goodness. God, it's like a Eric Dion, PhD, CDDDDBDDU. Like, really, you're getting a long Esquire. You got to add Esquire to your name, too.
Sure.
Or GQ magazine kind of thing.
When everything kind of exploded with making that announcement, it just got really, really busy for me and my crew. And it just got really incredible and very intense, very fast. And that's what slowed everything down. But, you know, we caught up. Everything got done. And was able to get some help, thank God, and say, you know what, I just have to take care of this. I made promises that I have to keep. You know, my best friend Andre really needs to get this done, and I wanted to get it done. So we got
it. Well, I know where you live, so I had no problem getting in my car and going down there.
Yeah.
Well, just BTR is so excited. I did play a sneak peek of it last Sunday at the Queer Tea Dance, but it wasn't as remastered as what we're going to hear right now. It took a
few retakes because there were things we were so rushed to try to get it done. We were so past due, like almost a week, and we basically everything was piling on, and every time I did a polishing, I put it back, and then I'm like, I forgot something, and I had to bring it back and put it back out.
We need to do it again.
Even today. Like,
we have to record the whole thing again. No, I'm kidding.
But even today, remember, I messaged you, and I said, oh my God, I forgot the oohs and the ahs.
Yeah, so... I've been actually listening to it. So a few select people have been granted access to listen to it, mainly radio stations and producers, just to get some feedback on it. But I've continued to listen to it. And I do have to say my favorite version is the original mix. The original mix is what's going to be played on Sunday. And I'm hoping that it's taken up. It's 7 minutes, which is still pretty good, but you need seven minutes of dancing, folks. Like, get off your rump and dance whenever you hear the song. Because
the original mix is specifically made for DJs who mix
for radio. Yeah,
there is a radio version, like a radio edit version, which cuts the beginning and the end just for radio. And, you know, it's quick to get into the song and quick to get out. But when you come to spinning in a nightclub, you need some sort of segue from one song to the other. So a lot of remixes
song
in closing.
Yeah.
So that's
all right,
let's original
play the sneak peek.
What's that?
Let's play the sneak peek. Your camera is delayed. Longer than Stairway to Heaven. So John was like, longer than Stairway to Heaven, for fuck's sakes, just kidding. So 7 minutes is Stairway to Heaven is 7 minutes, isn't it?
I think Stairway to Heaven is longer.
I think Stairway to Heaven is longer.
I think it is longer.
All right, let's play the single. So here we go. I'm gonna mute us and play the single.
Summertime. For a summertime love, although my heart is still broken for that summertime. Summertime.
I gotta unmute us after that. Well,
little snippet. What's
that? Just a little snippet. That's just a little snippet. Yeah. So it's based on someone I met many, many years ago, and dating apps. We live close. Yeah, and the rest is the song. The picture, thank you. Chrissy loves the picture. It was taken at a girlfriend's cottage of mine, Kelly yeah. Kitten Girl. I went on to that doc and I was like, oh my God, it has to be. It was a perfect picture for the, it's not professionally done. It's just my Android. So if Gaga can shoot a video on a phone, so can I. John was saying that Stairway to Heaven is 802. So we're that close of being that long. But
I knew it was longer. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Like you said, it was from an experience that you told me about. And when I decided to write it, we wanted to ask someone else to write it for us. Yes. And then that didn't pan out. And I ended up writing it.
Yeah,
and I was very, very
inspired, and you started to write it. So
yeah, I did. I was inspired by the story and the. I mean, there's more to the story than what is actually said in the song. I mean, there's actual heartbreak, but we didn't want to put that in there because the song is way more happier, and I wanted to make it light and be able to say, you know what. Life goes on even after
heartbreak. It was heartbreak, but the heart healed and the heart grows stronger, and the heart doesn't put up with a lot of shit after that.
Yeah. And I get to write often. You know, I don't write very often. And when I do, it's because it's something that really inspires me and I do feel something. And, you know, you being my best friend, I really couldn't help myself. It just came pouring out. So,
yeah, for sure. Well, yeah. I mean, it helps. That's why a lot of writers hang around for like an entire weekend or a week when they're doing stuff like that, right? Because then they get to feel the energy and see what's going on. So summer in Canada is 6 minutes. Crew and summer love is 7 minutes. Oh, John is having a big, great debate on how long songs are now. So what's that?
You know, there's Tanula, there's one that beats everybody. Bottom Heavy is like 10 minutes long.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, you didn't do the extended version. Like earlier, I said it was like the remix, but we haven't even remixed it yet. Like,
no, but I am going to do a call out to a lot of other producers who want to give it their shot. If they want to do a remix of it, voice tracks are there, they're available, and either raw or with effects, and all they have to do is contact us and we'll take care of it. I would love to see, you know, newcomers and young folk who just begin in that kind of craft and give it their shot to make a really good remix and maybe even pull out a maxi single out of all.
That would be great. I mean, so the email went out late last night to a couple of record producers, and we'll see what happens. Yep. And if you're a record producer out there listening, make sure you listen at 3 p.m. on Sunday on the Capital Queer Tea Dance with DJ Zimwa Wee on blasttheradio.com as well as twitch.tv/diverseintocapital. And you're going to hear it. And I'm probably going to play it a couple of times on Sunday. And then hopefully it gets put into a yearly rotation on Blast the Radio.
Well, you know, there's more stuff coming out. I mean, there's a lot of other musics that I'm also working on. I'm also finishing stuff with Drake and excuse me. And you know, I gotta be honest with you. I have to thank you for getting me out of my rut.
Good.
Because I felt kind of stuck in a rut at one point, and when I wrote the song, it kind of got me inspired to do other things as well as far as writing and producing more stuff. And, you know, if you're a singer as well, if you guys are out there and you have some stuff written down, hey, shoot them over to us. We'll
Send it, yes. My niece is turning into quite the little singer, so we might have a new little protege as Uncle Andy to be able to record. So, well, thank you so much, Raj, for being here. I appreciate it. I appreciate you being here, and I look forward to seeing you on Sunday for the release. Sorry?
I'm going to try to make it. I'm not guaranteeing it, but I am going to give it my best shot. There's something I wanted to say. You guys were talking about earlier about reopening venues. I am going to be at Cleopatra on Friday, September 17th.
In Montreal.
So I'm going to be spinning for Dead Dolls Cabaret.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
So if you guys are in Montreal and you guys it's Friday on the 17th. If you guys are around, you're more than welcome. It's not going to be a huge show, but it's going to be, instead of saying cabaret, we're going to call it a cocktail. And, you know, it's trying to revive back up, you know, the show bars and all the drag shows in the venues and in the clubs, you know. And DJs
I'm a minute over. Jesus, why I was worried about filling time and I can't shut you up. What she said is next on Blast the Radio. I have to finish. But I'm going to post the info to your event on the Diversity in Capital Facebook page. Thank you so much, honey, for being here. I hope to see you on Sunday. And if you can't, well, then big virtual hug. Thank you so much for working on it. Take care of each other, Ottawa Gatineau, and we'll see you next week with some more guests on DITC Social.